All right, so you can see the various stage. I have the guitar out here. I was just testing it with these lads here. The connection going down. The bottom one there needs to be done. The one that's going to the neck. Storm Dennis has been racking the place here. Racking? I forgot what I was going to say. Reckon, but racking. Racking something. I forget the phrase. I've taken out the ESP and I'm waiting for a kind of decent light out there to kind of take some pictures of it. It's a real shame to have to sell this, but if I just kind of list it quick and hopefully I won't be worrying too much about it. But it's a class guitar. Just not getting used, you know, it's crazy. Just not getting used at all. I think I've said it before about the finish on the back of the neck. Just, I'm not a fan of a finish on the back of the neck of a guitar. Whoa. I'm gonna bust my own wrist doing that. Yeah, so I have to get photos taken and list it then. And my GoPro is beeping at me. It's not beeping out, it's flashing because my battery is at 6%. Lovely. Okay, we'll come back later and see how we're getting on. So that was about all I recorded for that first week. Later in the week, we got some bad news about my cousin Sean, who lives in Limerick. We originally got a message that he wasn't well, and it was kind of pretty serious. But the next message we got, it turns out he was after being admitted into palliative care. So we then got the dreaded phone call that he had actually passed away. So I made my way down to Galway and met up with my two brothers. So I got a chance to hang out with them down there for a couple of days, for both the removal and the funeral. We also managed to get a chance to go out and visit where my dad's ashes were spread. It was very annoying to see that people have started dumping rubbish along the river there, and they've actually put up a sign about no dumping, more or less right at the spot where his ashes were spread. The weather was pretty bad when we were down there. It was very, very cold, and we were kind of at that tail end of that storm. Also got a chance then to pass my dad's childhood house as well, and Sean would have grown up next door. That's where my uncle lived there. My cousin Sean hadn't been well for a long time. He was in a bad accident about 15 years before this, which left him in a wheelchair. And I think he's kind of constantly been suffering ever since. But I guess that accident finally caught up with him. It was weird because I met loads of people at the removal that I hadn't seen in possibly about 30 years. I think he would have enjoyed his removal. He had a lot of friends who kind of got up and said a few things about him and told some funny stories. It was also very interesting that at the graveyard, as they were lowering his coffin down, they actually played One by Metallica. So it was interesting to see a lot of the older people's reactions as the song was playing away, because it does actually last about 6 minutes. He would have had a good laugh at that. Just trying to get this vlog up. Ugh. Keep getting that on the head. After I pass by. You alright, pal? Having dinner? Just trying to cook dinner here.
Hi, pal.
So we have another storm out there. Doesn't know what it's doing. It's kind of snowing and raining. We're expecting a really bad wind tonight. And today, it's going to be pretty crazy. Again.
I really like Goofy, right?
You do?
There he is. And he's eating all of the homework.
Mm-hmm. He's a teacher, is he?
Yeah.
Okay, we're at the end of week 165. I think it's 165. I didn't put a video up last week because I actually recorded very little stuff. So instead of just filling it with rubbish, I filled this week with rubbish instead and put it into a double week. I don't really want to be doing that. I'd prefer to have kind of like it weekly done. But we had kind of like crazy stuff happen last week. I was to get that guitar, and I got a message that my cousin, Sean, was pretty sick. But we later found out anyway that he was actually in palliative care. So we wound up having to go down for the funeral, down to Limerick, which was pretty crazy, you know. But was down there anyway and got to kind of hang out with the brothers for a while, which was great. And that was about it, really. I recorded a little bit of footage. You would have seen it already. That's about it. Just spent most of the time just chatting away and, you know, just listening to music. And, you know, it's not the kind of place to pull the camera out, really. Yeah, that's about it. I sold the ESP. Well, it's right here in front of me, but provisionally sold for a lot less than I thought I was going to get for it. But at the same time, there's no point in having it there if I'm not going to use it, you know. Yeah, I have a couple of people asking about the rack stuff there, but I'm kind of, I don't really want to part with any of that stuff at the moment, especially the switching gear. We'll see. I got inquiries about the power amp there, but sure, because it's a Brunetti and nobody kind of knows the make, they kind of don't pay much attention to it, but it is an amazing power amp. It's a hand-wired Italian-made power amp, you know. Brunetti are a great company. They have some amazing amplifiers, actually. But anyway, it's going to be a few weeks before I can sell the ESP. The guy wanted to meet me in the first week of March, I think it was, because obviously he didn't have the money at the time. Seems like a nice guy anyway, so I will sell that to him. And then you have this coronavirus. I wanted to ramble about this last week, and because of stuff that went on, I didn't get to ramble about it. And I wanted to ramble about it the week before, and I actually did go off on a rant on it. But I edited it out because it was taking too long. I think I went on like a 15-minute rant or something. I'm not going to rant about it today. The reason I'm bringing it up is I don't know if we'll be able to kind of travel. I'm going to have to travel to sell that guitar to that guy, you know, so I'm not sure how things are going to be at that stage. As of tonight, which is Saturday, I think it's the 28th. I have no idea. The 29th of February. So as of tonight, we had one person confirmed with it in the Republic of Ireland here. Apparently he travelled from northern Italy or something like that. Look, the media has kind of put about this. They're talking about a 2-week incubation period. That's only like for like a handful of people. It seems to be like 21 days to 28, I believe it is. Plus, they have, I heard on the radio this morning a doctor actually saying that Like, it's insane. He said that, like, if you sneeze or cough or whatever, you know, blah, 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 if it's on something, it only lasts 3 hours. That's completely untrue. It lasts 9 days. They've already proven that, like, way back at the end of January, you know. I don't talk about this stuff that's going on because I don't want to kind of have this channel as something that I'm kind of talking about these kind of things, you know. Otherwise, I would have been talking about this a lot over the last couple of days, especially over the last couple of weeks, actually. If anybody knows me on Facebook or whatever, you'll know yourself that I've been rambling about this since mid-January. You know, I am not rambling about it, but I'd put up the odd post when I find something that's just a little bit fucking too weird. Like, I'll put it up there. But sure, nobody's been listening anyway. It's kind of pointless. Political-wise as well. You know, so I just don't talk about it here, like, but I just brought this up anyway because it's going to affect selling that guitar, you know, because I'll have to travel a couple of counties up to sell it to him. And then I'll have to order the stuff that I want online, you know, and that's going to kind of come from Germany as well. And I don't know what things are going to happen in the next 2 weeks. Because there's such a long incubation period with this. We're probably walking around with it ourselves. We probably have it already, you know, at this stage. Like, it's pretty crazy. It's pretty, it's easy to spread, you know. But anyway, look, I'm not worried about the coronavirus. I'm not. It's dangerous for some people. It could be dangerous for me. I don't know if I have a heart problem or not. Remember, I've been in and out of the fucking hospital over the last 2 years over something. I've no idea. That doesn't worry me. What worries me is the idiot fucking people who panic when this kind of thing happens, you know what I mean? And the people who didn't worry about it and then all of a sudden worry about it at the last minute is what kind of fucking freaks me out. And I don't want to kind of meet those people outside the shop or whatever, you know, when there's a panic about food shortages or, you know, because we've seen it already. If these places go into lockdown, any of these towns or villages where it kind of goes rampant, you know, there's no supplies coming in or out, you know, everything shuts down, you know, everything is kind of shutting down anyway. Anyway, I'll probably make a more coherent few minutes of, I'm just kind of shooting off the cuff here. I'm not actually, I don't have anything in front of me or whatever. Yeah, look, I'm going to leave it at that. Yeah, look, you know, they're going on about how they know about this. They know nothing about it. We're in the infancy of this. We don't know what the story is. We don't know if, you know, we don't know if you kind of recover from it or fully recover from it. Or if there's a second phase or a third phase of it. You know, we know nothing about that kind of thing. Yeah, it's worrying times, I suppose it is, yeah. But I'm more worried about my Native Instruments jam and selling that fucking guitar. That's my priority to get that sorted because I really want to sit down and kind of just mess with music again. And I'm kind of gone off guitar at the moment. I know it's not a permanent thing, but look, we'll see what happens. Anyway, I've rambled way too long. Yeah, sure, we'll talk to you next week.